worship the Lord this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We thank you, Jesus. We worship you. Hallelujah.
Thank you. You see, doesn't matter what the doctor may have told you this morning. Hallelujah. I want to tell somebody that Jesus is a healer. Hallelujah. Jesus is a deliverer. Hallelujah. Glory to your name, Jesus. Hallelujah. He's a friend that's sticking closer than a brother. Hallelujah. Only thing you have to do this morning is believe on him. Hallelujah. He'll come through for you. Can tell you that.
To open your hearts as my partner and companion and fellow laborer in this great work of faith comes to us to deliver the word that God has given to her. Why not lift up your hands and just worship God and rejoice and believe God that He's going to speak to your heart as Minister Davis joins us to declare, thus saith the Holy Ghost.
Just join hand with your neighbor for me just now. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to God. Hallelujah. We worship you, Jesus. All praise, all glory, all honor we give to you this morning. Lord, you know there is none like you. You know there's none that can be compared. You set your glory above the heavens. The heavens declare your glory, God. And the firmament show it your handiworks. This is another day that you have made. And you say we should rejoice and be glad in it. And God, we come here this morning. It's not for entertainment. But we come here this morning, Lord, and trust in our lives in your hand. We ask this morning, oh God, that you bear down in the service. Let your Holy Ghost, no other spirit, but the Spirit of the Holy Ghost, let him ascend right now. Hey, glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Lord, we pray every other spirits that are not of God this morning, we nullify them. We thank authority over them. We pray the Holy Ghost of God will rest heavily in the service this morning. No flesh will glory in your presence, God. You shall be seen in your fullness this morning. Oh God, somebody here needs a miracle. Somebody here, divine God, come with open hearts this morning. Believe in you, God, for a supernatural encounter. It's not in our power, Lord. We're only channels and vessels. But we come to you again. Speak to us, God. Speak to us this morning. Let us hear your voice. The anointing of God will trash this place this morning. The anointing of God. Hey, glory, 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 glory. Hey, glory to God. Holy Ghost invasion this morning. In the name of Jesus Christ. Not one soul will walk through these doors the way they came, God. But they'll have a personal encounter this morning. Touch, Lord. Make a difference now. I'm only a vessel longing to be used by you, Lord. I entrust my all to you now. Your waiting audience, God. Oh, glory. Lord, let me do justice to your word. Breathe upon us now, we pray. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Everything that can be shaken. Oh, glory to God. Will be shaken this morning. All to your glory. All to your honor. All to your praise. I tell you thanks again. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Just wave those hands and praise him. Just wave those hands and love him. Just wave those hands and exalt him. Give him his glory this morning. We are here to see no other but Jesus Christ and him crucified. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I want you to just embrace one person just before you are seated and tell them the King is in residence here. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. 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 Be exalted, oh God. Be exalted, oh God. Be exalted, Lord. Glory, glory, glory. God bless you. You can be seated. I love you, Jesus. I really love you, Jesus. Oh, glory to God. I extend my greetings and my salutation to our Bishop, the Reverend Dr. Davis, to all of the ministers of God, the beautiful Echoes of Faith Choir that have blessed us and ministered to us so richly. To all of the parents who came by to have dedicated your little ones to the Lord, we thank you for making it Power of Faith. And we are happy to have you this morning to include 4 members of the ministry. Praise God. God is adding to the church, and we give God thanks. And to the General Assembly, the beautiful audience, members and visitors alike, just give yourself a big hand this morning. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. It's really a blessing to be here this morning, and I give God thanks. All I need is your sincere prayers, your open heart. Don't see me for who I am, and don't see me this morning. Just see Jesus Christ, because I'm only an instrument, and I avail myself to him this morning with the expectation that he will speak through me to you, and that each hearts and lives will be touched in a very personal way. God richly bless you at this time. I ask you to turn your Bibles with me to the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 11. 2 Corinthians chapter 11. I'm going to be reading from verse 22 to verse 33. And the Apostle Paul, he writes, "Are they Hebrews? So am I. Are they Israelites? So am I. Are they seeds of Abraham? So am I. Are they ministers of Christ? I speak as a fool. I am more in labor, more in abundant, more in stripes above measure, in prison more frequent in death of the Jews, 5 times receive I 40 stripes, save one. Thrice was I beaten with rods. Once I was stoned. Thrice I suffered shipwreck. A night and a day I've been in the deep. In journeyings often. In perils of waters. In perils of robbers. In perils by my own countrymen. In perils by the brethren, by the heathen, in perils in the city, in perils in the wilderness, in perils in the sea, in perils among false brethren, in weariness and painfulness, in watching often, in hunger and thirst, in fasting often, in cold and nakedness, beside those things that are without, that which cometh upon me daily, the care of all the churches. Who is weak? I am not weak. Who is offended? And I burned not. If I must need glory, I will glory of the things which concerning my infirmities. The God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, which is blessed forevermore, know that I lie not. In Damascus, the governor under Artus, the king, kept the city of the Damascus with garrisons, desiring to apprehend me, and through a window in a basket was I let down by the wall and escaped his hand. And through a window in a basket, I was let down by the wall and escaped his hand. My theme to us this morning is, I am a survivor. Young adult choir, I am a survivor. Ministers of the gospel, I am a survivor. To the general assembly, I am a survivor. I want you to touch yourself and tell yourself this morning, I am a survivor. Oh, glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. I just give you a little information, just a little definition, briefly, on who is a survivor, so you can have a broader and a wider knowledge of who you are, of who we are in the Lord. A survivor is one who remains alive or in existence. To live or exist beyond death or occurrence. One living through a time, event, or development marked by death of others, but you survive. So what killed others? You survived. To outlive or to outlast. I am a survivor. That which takes the life of others. Sometimes it could have been a catastrophe. In Louisiana and in other places where the tsunami took place, 1,000 died. But guess what? All did not die. There were survivors. So there may be things happening around you. There are circumstances and situations that are taking the lives of others. But because you are a survivor, you are going to outlive it. You are going to outlast it. You shall not die. David said in Psalms 117 and verse 17, I shall not die, but live and declare the works of the Lord. Touch yourself and say, I shall not die. I will not die. I am a survivor. Hey, glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You see, God has not promised us skies always blue. There will be dark clouds. Flowers strew path all our lives through. God has not promised us sunshine without rain. Joy without sorrow. Peace without pain. Hallelujah. God has not promised we shall not have toil and temptation, trouble and war. He had not told us we shall not bear many burdens, many care. But God hath promised strength for the day, rest for the labor, light for the way, grace for the trials, help from above, unfailing sympathy, and undying love. God promised in our glory to God, Isaiah chapter 42. He said, when you go through the waters, I'm going to be with you. When you go through the flood, it shall not overflow you. When you go through the fire, you shall not burn, neither shall its flame kindle upon you, because you are a survivor. Fire can't burn you. Water can't drown you. Hey, glory to God. I will put you in the fire. I will put you in the river. But God will make you float. God will bear you up. You can't drown. You cannot die. You are going to outlive. Hallelujah. You see, I want us to know who we are and whose we are. Yes, when you get to know that, you'll not let the devil walk over you. You'll take your true position and you will declare your position in God. The word of God says in the book of Jeremiah chapter 20, there was a priest by the name of Pasor, the son of Immer, the priest who also was a chief governor of the house of the Lord. And Jeremiah prophesied those things. He smote Jeremiah and put him in stocks. And on the morrow, Pasor brought Jeremiah out of the stock. And Jeremiah told him that the Lord has not called his name Pasor anymore. his name is now Magog Meshach. What a name. But there's a significance. Jeremiah is a servant of God. And I just cannot understand why people don't love the truth. If you tell people lie, they are quicker to believe you and to love you for the lie. If you tell people the truth, people don't want to hear the truth. If you are genuine to them that don't know your genuineness, they are quicker to go to a hypocrite, because they will take side. They will cover up. If you are my friend, tell me the truth. It's only the truth can make me free. God is not pleased with some of us because we portray too much hypocrisy. You're afraid to tell people the truth. If you're wrong, you're just wrong. How will I help you if I condone with you in your wrong? Any friend you have, because you know when you're wrong, you know. You are aware when you are wrong. But nobody wants to acknowledge the wrong. And so you seek sharp shoulder for comfort. Any friend you have, and that friend takes side with you in your wrong, they are no friends at all. You need to break link. Your friend must can tell you the truth. Here we see it in the scripture. Jeremiah, the prophet of God, anointed and called by him. In Jeremiah chapter 1 and verse 4, the word of God said to Jeremiah, "Before thou wast conceived in thy womb, I know thee. Before thou camest out, I sanctify thee and ordained thee a prophet." Jeremiah mean the Lord hurls. You know when you hurl something, you trust. And Jeremiah was a servant of God. He realized his call was different from many of the other prophets. He was called with a mission, and he had to tell the people the truth. And he cries more than any other of the prophets. He was called the weeping prophet because he wept over the sins of Israel. Oh, glory to God. And here this unrighteous priest heard that Jeremiah prophesied and took the servant of God and placed him in stocks and put him away. But the word of God said, the following day, he took Jeremiah out of the stock, thinking that Jeremiah would have differed to please him. But Jeremiah looked him in the face and said, God said, if he tell you, Pastor, you will no longer be called Pastor, but your name shall be changed. Magog Meshach. Pasor means largeness on every side. Largeness, blessings, prosperity. So that was his name initially before in trouble God's servant. But God said, you don't have that blessing anymore. You lose it. You touch me anointing. You trouble me anointing. So I'm going to stretch out my hands against you. No more, Pastor. Largeness on every side. Your name now is Magog Meshach. Terror. Terror on every side. You shall be a terror to yourself. You shall be a terror to your friends. You shall be a terror to everybody around you. Lord Jesus, have mercy. Be careful. Not trouble God's anointed. Not try to hinder what God is doing. God, we change your name. Largeness, increase, prosperity, blessings on every side. But because you're trouble God's servant, you're going to be a terror to yourself, terror to those around you. You're going to be miserable. You're going to be tormented. You're going to be confused. Oh, Rabaya Koshehe. Rababakoshandalabahaya. But it did not stop there. Put yourself in Jeremiah's position. You know you're called of God. You are mandated by God. You're not given a choice because God has called you forth. You know you are doing right. You know you are living right. You know you are fulfilling what God called you, the purpose for which God called you. And you are cast aside and you are placed in stock, mean chain. You are put away. You are shackled and put away in prison for the gospel of Jesus Christ. Jeremiah said from verse 9, then said I will not make mention of him, nor speak anymore in his name, Lord Jesus. But, conjunction, but, I feel, and I feel like I can't bother. I feel like I won't pack it up. I feel like I won't call it a day. Because why? Jeremiah said, I will not make mention and not talk about Jesus and God anymore. But, touch yourself and say, but, because I am a survivor. But, oh Jesus, touch yourself again and say, but it not stop there. It's a conjunction. It joins two sentences or two statements. Jesus. But his word was in mine heart as a burning fire shut up in my bones. And I was weary for holding back, for forbearing. And I could not stay. Couldn't stay. Something bigger than me. Something more than me is in control. So because of that, I can't hold back. Do or die, I have to. Because there's a call. There's a purpose. And because I shall not die, because I am a survivor, I will outlive, I will outlast every circumstance this morning. I am weary. Hey, I am weary. I'm holding back. Holy Ghost, say, I hold back. Let go. Hey. Oh, glory to God. The Holy Ghost said, you are a survivor. Don't let situations hold you back. Oh, Jesus. My. Glory. Hey. The devil wants to shackle you. Satan wants to shackle you. and to render you powerless, but break loose. You will not hold back. You will not forbear. Hallelujah. 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 I come to unshackle somebody this morning. You're coming out. You're getting in your rightful place. You're taking your rightful position. It's time. You are a survivor. Oh, glory, 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 glory. Hey, yeah, Lord. Yeah, Lord. Hallelujah. Fire in his bones. He went a little further. He said, I hear, for I heard the defaming. Yes. They said derogatory things. They said demean things about you. Because Satan is on a mission. Don't listen. Jeremiah said, I hear all that they have said. But guess what? I am a survivor. I have something in me. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I heard the defaming of many. Fear on every side. Report, say they. Report. And we will report it. What you go report, say? You lying devil. What you want to report? You know it's not from God. Hold your peace. You can't report. The Holy Ghost bombard you. The Holy Ghost curfew you. You're telling lies. The Holy Ghost said, you will not speak. Why are you report, say? Lord Jesus. Listen to this. All my familiars. These are not enemies, no. These are your so-called friends. Your acquaintances. Your familiars. Those who you think are your buddy. Friend. Jeremiah says, all my familiars. Watch for my halting. Watch to see you fall. Watch to see you become a reproach. It's not your enemy, you know. David said, if it was an enemy that have done it unto me, I would have borne it. But it is my familiars, my acquaintances, that we have sweet fellowship and we go to the house of God together. Enemies will never get close enough more time to hurt you. It's those that dip in the cup. All my familiars, they watch for my halting. Saying, peradventure, I'll be enticed, and we shall prevail against him, and we shall take our revenge on him. But another conjunction again, them waiting, them looking, them watching. They are in anticipation. But guess what? The Lord is with me as a mighty and terrible one. Oh, glory to God. The Lord is with me as a mighty and terrible one. Jesus, therefore, my persecutors shall stumble. They shall not prevail. They shall be greatly ashamed, for they shall not prosper. Their everlasting confusion shall never be forgotten. God, I will confuse them. Me say, God, I will confuse them. God, I will turn them into idiot. Glory. Lord, have mercy. Touch yourself and say, I am a survivor. The Lord is with me as a mighty and terrible one. My enemies shall not prevail. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. My enemies shall not prevail. They shall be brought low. They shall be confounded. Their everlasting confusion shall not depart from them. God, we confuse them. Vengeance is mine, said the Lord. I will repay. All I say to us this morning, be careful what you talk about God's people. And be careful how you treat God's people. Romans, hallelujah. The book of Romans, the word of God, Paul said, for I reckon that the sufferings of this present time, they are not worthy to be compared with the glory that shall be revealed in us. Let me say something to us. Smooth, I want you to listen carefully. Smooth sea does not produce good sailors. And I repeat it one more time for you to get it. Smooth sea, S-E-A, the water, the big ocean. Smooth sea does not produce good, skillful sailors. You can build the most beautiful ship and keep it ashore. You never know the durability of that ship until you throw it out in the ocean. And if the sea is smooth, you still don't know how durable that ship is. But when that ship is out there and water start gushing, 20-foot wave start beat upon that ship, and the ship anchor hole, and the water just a rock, but the ship is anchored. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hey, Lord Jesus, ship can't sail itself. The sailor determine whether that ship survive or that ship come to a wreck. That sailor has to have skillful ways of knowing how to turn, when to turn, how to follow the wind, that your ship is not destroyed. So when everything going good and you can't smile, you not say nothing yet. When you have money in the bank and you are in good health, and you have a good marriage or a good family life, you have a good job that is smooth sea, you anybody can see it, is when water gets rough, is when water gets, hallelujah! Hey! Hallelujah! Jesus, Jesus, Jesus! Hey! Hallelujah! Somebody's on rough sea. Somebody's out on rough sea. Somebody's facing some 20-foot wave. Water coming in on your ship. You feel like you're gonna die. Touch yourself and tell yourself, I shall not die. I am a survivor. Steer your course. Steer your course. Don't brighten with wave. Jesus is on board. Hey! The battle is not yours. It is the Lord. Hey, hey, Bekosha. Fire. Glory. Rabba Bekosha and Rabba Laya. You're not dead. You're coming out. Ask you for maybe another 5 or so minutes. Hallelujah. 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 Just seal right. Glory. I tell you something this morning. It is said that a man had a very faithful donkey. The donkey, he worked tirelessly. He served his master wholeheartedly. But after a time, the donkey got a bit old, so he could not perform as effectively as he used to perform. His master did not seek to sell him. He claimed nobody would have wanted the donkey. So his best option was to dig a pit, put the donkey in the pit, bury the donkey, and get rid of the donkey. The donkey is a survivor. The donkey said, me not ready for dead yet. I am going to live because I'm not finished. I can still do not as much as I used to. So the donkey formed a plan in his mind. The man dig a deep pit and threw the donkey down in there. Man did a shovel dirt, man. He never looked upon the donkey. He just a shovel dirt upon the donkey. And every time he shovel the dirt, the donkey shake it up, stamp on it, come up a little further. Aye! Hallelujah! So the man shovel dirt, the donkey shake it up, step on it, come up a little further. Lord Jesus, somebody had trouble me this morning. When the donkey shake and in stamp, when it reached to a point, the donkey just walk out. I am a survivor. I shall live. And I shall not die. I shall live and declare the works of the Lord. Satan, have some of you in a pit, in a true dirt. No, lie down, I'm dead. Get up. Get up. Shake off. Stomp on it. You're coming out. Dead and make Satan bury you and make you suffocate and dead after your business, but there is a way out. Shake off him dirt, shake off, stamp on it, come out and claim your victory. You are a survivor. Try to close, even though I'm not finished. Oh, glory. I read about in my text the Apostle Paul, and I will not get in depth as time will not allow me, but you know he was a persecutor of the Church of God. He killed an imprisoned Christian, but in the book of Acts chapter 9, when he had his letters of destruction on his way down to Damascus to persecute the Christians. God met him on the way. God knocked him off his horse, lay him flat on the ground. And when the Apostle Paul realized somebody bigger than him was now in charge, he said, "Lord, what will thou have me to do? It is hard to kick against the prick." And the Lord called him and sent him into ministry. It is said he wrote 13 of the New Testament books. And you know, he said this morning, concerning persecution, concerning perils, concerning suffering, he said, "I suffer more than anyone else." He said, "I was shipwrecked. I was beaten. I was hungry. I was thirsty. I was abandoned. I was neglected." But he said, "Who is weak? I am not weak. I am strong this morning because I am a survivor." But it did not stop there. The word of God said in the book of Acts chapter 27 and 28, which I will not read, but I will just make statements from. Paul was with 276 prisoners for the gospel of Jesus Christ, going to Italy to be tried for the gospel. And the word of God said in chapter 27, he was given over to one Julius. He was a centurion from the Augustus band. But God don't make a mistake. The Lord knew the heart of Julius. And in verse 3, the word of God said that Paul was given permission to go and fellowship with his associates and his friends. But further down in the verse, the water became very treacherous and the wind became contrary. Paul said to the shipmasters, "Do not sail, because if we sail, we are going to get into serious trouble." But they, not believing the servant of God, they went and they sailed. The word of God said they encountered a Euroclydon is an east wind, comes out of the Mediterranean Sea. The scripture says it is a very rare one. It doesn't happen very often. So God was giving a message, because they did not obey Paul. They encountered a Euroclydon. But it did not stop there. The mission continued. It got worse. Hallelujah. Paul said, hallelujah, in verse 20 of 27 chapter, "And when neither sun nor stars in many days appear, and no small tempest lay on," hallelujah, "and all hope that we should be saved was then taken away." All hope. Hope lost means everything. Because when you lose hope, there's nothing else. Hope is what the believers base their faith on, based on what the word of God says. When they look on the condition that exists, all hope was gone that any man would stay alive. But guess what? The servant of God, the Apostle Paul, who is a survivor, was on board. And he said, "Lord Jesus, now I exhort you to be of all good cheer, for there shall be loss of no man's life among you, but of the ship. For there stood by me this night the angel of God, whose I am and whom I serve, saying, Fear not, Paul. Thou must be brought before Caesar. And Lord God has given thee all them that sail with thee. All hope was lost, but the servant of God stood in the bridge and he spoke upon the authority of God's word. He said, be of good cheer. No life will be lost, save the cargo and the ship, because there stood by me this night the angel of God, whose I am and who I serve. I shall not die. I shall stand before Caesar to declare the word of Almighty God. You think it stopped there? In chapter 28, after the ship was wrecked, they came where two seas meet, and the ship stuck and would not give way. So the ship rent apart. And Paul said, the shipmaster there, Julius said to them, all who can swim, swim to shore. But before all of that, the verse above said they was going to kill all the prisoners. But because Julius knew who Paul was, and because of Paul's sake, he would not allow them to kill the prisoners along with Paul. He said, who can swim, swim. Who can swim, take pieces of the ship and get to shore. Not one life was lost. The servant of God spoke it, and God honored his word. And the scripture says, they came to a little place called Melita. The people were barbarous. It means it would be savage and ignorant, but in this sense, that's what it means. They were not from Rome. They were not Greeks. So they were seen as barbarians. So the scripture said they built a fire, because all 276 prisoners that came to shore was wet, and it was winter, so it was very cold. So the people of the little city made a fire and put them there for them to warm. When the fire started to go out, the apostle Paul went to gather stick. You get one blow already, and you're not dead. You think Satan give up? You get another blow again. You think Satan give up? But guess what? The harder they come, is the harder they fall. Oh, glory! Oh, glory! So, they thought maybe it was okay now. They got over the sea. They were secured in a little city. So Paul went to gather his sticks. When he gathered his sticks, and he put out and put on the fire, a venomous viper snake hunched onto his hand. If the doctor is even in your pocket, and that venomous thing stings you, you die instantly. You just swell and drop dead. Don't let people deter you. And don't let people's word cause you to feel anyway. Know the God that you serve. When the people saw the venomous beast, the viper, the snake, the deadly viper on the hand of the servant of God, you hear what them say? This man must be a murderer. Although him escape the vengeance of the sea, but vengeance suffered it not to live. That's a fatal blow. That's the final one we're supposed to take life. But guess what? Paul just shake it off in the fire. You have to have a fire to destroy your enemy. Shake it off in the fire. You shall not die. Yes, you're a murderer. And although you escape the sea, vengeance suffer you not to live. Looking for Paul to swell, drop, dead. But when they look upon the Apostle Paul, Lord Jesus have mercy. Paul just shake himself. Say, you don't know who I am. I am a survivor. I am called for a purpose. You meant it for evil, but God meant it for good. I am going to declare the works of the Lord. And the same people that spoke those unkind words, when they looked on the servant of God and he stood his ground, they said, Lord Jesus, I'm not an ordinary man. This man is some God. Is only some God could resist the sting of this deadly viper. Satan bites, he stings, but the Holy Ghost give you immunity. Him sting can't take no effect. Him sting can't poison you. Him sting can't destroy you. I am a survivor. I outlive and I outlast everything that was meant for evil. God, turn it around for my good. Are there any survivors in here this morning? Satan has tried every strategy. He has devised everything that you can think of. But this morning, you can raise your hand and say, I have survived. I am more than conqueror through him that loved me. In the name of Jesus, I shall not die. Oh, glory to God. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. The viper's sting will not take your life as long as you remain with God. You are a survivor. Hallelujah. That which come up against you, as long as you deal with it in the right way, you shall not die. Satan want to kill some of you. Satan want to destroy some of you. But this morning you're going to take your stand. You're going to take your position. You're going to say, God, see me again. I can't do it on my own. God, I need you. I will not let the devil kill me. Touch yourself and say, Satan, you can't kill me. By the grace of God, you can't kill me. Satan, I will not let you kill me. I am under the blood. 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 The blood. The blood. I will not die. I will not die. I refuse to die. Winning blood. Winning blood. Winning blood. I'm coming out. I'm coming out. I'm coming out. I'm shaking myself. I'm coming out. As you come, raise both hands. As you come, raise both hands. Just raise your hand. There may be sickness in your body. You will not die. Let it come alive. Erekosha. Rababa koshendelebe. Riandalababaya kosha haya. In the name of Jesus, I speak in life. I speak in life. I speak in life. Life! Oh, glory, 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 glory. Glory, 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 glory. Glory, glory. Shake yourself. Shake yourself. Shake it off. Shake it off. You're coming out. Shake it off. Break loose. Break loose. And shackle yourself. Yes! 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 Shake off Satan dirt! Shake it off! Run, 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 run,
hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let us reach out to God in prayer right now, everybody. Reach out to God in prayer. Survivors never stop. Survivors never stop. Father, in the name of Jesus, we worship you, we praise, we honor you, we adore you. We thank you because you have made it possible through the blood of your cross, through the anointing of your spirit. Oh, that everyone who trusts in you, God, shall be as Mount Zion, cannot be removed but abide it forever. For as the mountains are round about Jerusalem, so the Lord is round and about his people. And the rod of the wicked shall not rest upon the lot of the righteous, save and except the righteous put forth his hands to iniquity. And they that wait upon your God shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. Run and not weary, walk and not faint. In the name of Jesus, as you stood by your servant Paul, through all his difficulties and his dangers, oh God, through debts and imprisonment and abandonment and shipwreck and enemies without and within. But oh God, you gave him the sufficiency of your grace, and you caused people to recognize, oh, the worth of your servant and assist to save his life. In a basket he was let down through a window. Oh God, to survive the planned attack of the enemy. Will you provide somebody a basket this morning? Provide somebody a window this morning. Provide somebody some helping hands this morning. Somebody need helping hands. Somebody need a basket. Somebody need a window. Somebody need to realize that you will make a way somehow in the name of Jesus. Make way for that brother. Make way for that sister. Make way for that man, that woman, that boy, that girl. Defeat the enemy left, right, and center. And give your people the victory now. In the name of Jesus. Let everyone survive the attack of the enemy. Sicknesses and disease, let them survive them. Poverty and distress, let them survive them.